name's Sarah Bennett. I'm the visual effects supervisor. The first thing everybody always says is like, you know, how gory is it going to be? And it's not gory just for the sake of it. I mean, it has to be set in reality. Obviously, if you're slitting someone's throat and you hit the jugular, it is naturally going to be gory, but it's not that type of film. It's not meant to be that type of film.
My name's David Malinowski, and I'm the prosthetics designer. The interesting thing about this job is that the prosthetics that we create, they have to regenerate. So we're working heavily with visual effects to try and find out the best way for that to happen. You know, how much involvement we have with prosthetics, how much we have with makeup, and how much we have with visual effects.
And because it's regenerating, we're showing that whole healing process. Let's say you cut yourself, you know, it might take over, I don't know, a few days to heal. You get scabbing, maybe bruising, depending on how severe the wound is. So we need to kind of show that as a progress, but it needs to happen, you know, very quickly, because obviously you don't want to be looking at it for a very long time. It'll be a very boring film. Every time we talk about each scene, it's like, what can makeup do? What can the prosthetics bring to it? Is this better to do it as a VFX? It's always nice, I think, to have a bit of reality when you're shooting. So to have a physical thing in the shot. So as well for us, it gives us lighting and it's kind of like a base.
I'm Alessandro Bertolazzi. I'm the makeup and hair designer on this project, The Old Guard. We have to start from one start, from point one, is like prosthetic and makeup. Between the first step and the second one is VFX.
It hurts everywhere. How bad is it?
It's an improvement.
For like Booker, when he gets his wounds, that was a prosthetic because, you know, it helps with the performance as well. The prosthetic gives us a base and then we'll build the depth and the sort of the moving parts within that as, you know, he starts to regenerate. So for that, we had three stages of prosthetics. The first one, which is quite an extensive sort of body piece, we just laid sort of green foam into it so that we could do the sort of next stage because we want to see things moving around and healing. And it was good to have, you know, something to work with from the lighting point of view, tracking, all of that. Those sort of big three key areas, you know, that all need to work together.
See, you're already healing faster.
Each character is challenging. Each character has their own story. It's like a music. It's like the 12 notes, but each music are completely different.
Play dead, motherfucker.